So one thing I had mentioned in talking about the some of the task manager changes is the ability to attach tasks to pre and post processing steps when using the ILS integrations. So I'm gonna show you how that works here now. So I open the Mock Editor. I configured a version that connects to test instance of Alma. You can see here that there are the two options that have always been there, which is a search and update create for either bid or holding records. There's a third option now called process settings. That allows you to do things like this. So here I have my task manager. I created an Alma post-processing step. So this will delete 500 fields, then add a new one that basically says that it was edited by the post-processing step. So I will go ahead and close these. And so we're going to go ahead and go get a record. So I have a record that I tend to work on. A couple of updates here in this interface. If you've been following the Z3950 SRU integration, I've collapsed the options when settings. So if you need to change either the database or number of records returned or whether or not the data is retrieved by Unicode. In this case, it's SRU, so it's by default Unicode, so you don't have to select that option. You can open up the box here and select your values. Otherwise, you can leave it closed and not worry about it. So I'm going to go ahead and search the Alma instance. So I get my results. I'm going to take this record because this is in my institutional zone, so I can edit it. And you can see my record set here. So inside this record, you'll see that there are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 500 fields. I'm going to go ahead and go to my process settings. And so you can see here, this allows me to select tasks that run on import. So when I pull records from Z39 or the SRU or the API instance, I can select a task to process when that data comes into the Mock Editor. I can also select options here to run tasks when the data is uploaded to whatever service I'm using. And so that's the one I'm going to set. So I'm going to go ahead and select my post-process set and save that. I'm not going to make any other changes because I just want to show the changes with the 500 fields. So I'm going to go ahead and update that record. The process was made and the records have been updated. You can see here, when the task is run, when you run the update, you could see very quickly the process window tell you did some things. But we can also see the end result step. But if we go back to our Alma instance, title again, pull the record down. You can see here that indeed the other 500 fields have been removed and just the post-processing step remains. So this allows you to essentially create macros or tasks the same way that we sometimes create them in things like connection, where on maybe export you have a task that add, or you have a macro that adds a command line field and you don't want to forget that. You can create tasks that you can attach to export in the Mock Edit process. You can run as many of the tasks as you want. You can stack them, although I'm not quite sure I'd want to have a lot of tasks running on export each time, or I would think import would be more likely because you could see the results before they get passed on to the server. But this is a way so that particularly the use case was for users in consortia, where maybe there's a consortial field that needs to be added or a consortial field that needs to be deleted. That can be done as just the part of the update step. That way it doesn't get forgotten. So I think that'll be a decent addition. One thing I will note is that you will see that the changes here are tagged to the ILS integration. there's really no good reason why I couldn't do the same thing so that tasks could respond to actions within the Mark editor, so that maybe on save or on compile, specific tasks run. Although I'm not quite sure there's a super good use case for that, so I'd have to have someone express what that need would be, or what that use case would be before building some additional pre-processing, post-processing into the application. But I think for integration work, this seems to be an option that I can definitely see why you might need it, and actually have some real world examples of where this kind of process would be used. So that's the new change.